my God. When I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars,
I see the stars,
I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe display. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art.
When through the woods and forest glades I mountain grandeur and see the brook and feel the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found, was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught the heart to fear, and grace my fear relieved. How precious did that grace appear
far, and grace will lead me home.
The Lord has promised good to me, His word my hope secures.
Speed.
Good morning. God is good. Invite all to stand and follow the procession as we sing our gathering song. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, full of compassion and mercy and abounding in steadfast love.
Amen.
Trusting God's gentle grace and the counsel of the Holy Spirit, let us be still and know that God is God. I invite the congregation to kneel or be seated. In the quiet, still moments, we come to know the Spirit who has already been given to us. The pains and struggles we encounter in our solitude thus become the way to hope. As our hope is not based on something that will happen after our sufferings are over, but on the real presence of God, healing Spirit, in the midst of these sufferings. Every time we listen with great attentiveness to the voice that calls each of us the beloved, hear our Lord's voice and his promise. I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. We stand and sing together song number 613. Be with you. Let's pray. Gracious God, your blessed Son came down from heaven to be the true bread that gives life to the world. Give us this bread always. that he may live in us and we in him. And that strengthened by this food, we may live as his body in the world. Through Jesus Christ, who is our Savior and our Lord. Amen. Congregation may be seated. And do we have any children here this morning to come up for a message? We will continue our 9 o'clock, unless some adults want to come up. Any adults want to come up? Message? Okay. We'll continue our worship then with our readings.
A reading from 1 Kings. Elijah went a day's journey into the wilderness and came and sat down under a solitary broom tree. He asked that he might die. "It is enough now, O Lord. Take away my life, for I am no better than my ancestors." Then he lay down under the broom tree and fell asleep. Suddenly an angel touched him and said to him, "Get up and eat." He looked, and there at his head was a cake baked on hot stones and a jar of water. He ate and drank and lay down again. The angel of the Lord came a second time, touched him and said, "Get up and eat, otherwise the journey will be too much for you." He got up and ate and drank. Then he went in the strength of that food 40 days and 40 nights. To Horeb, the Mount of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I bless God every chance I get. My lungs expand with his praise. Join me in spreading the news. Together, let's get the word out. Look at him, give him your warmest smile, never hide your feelings from him. God's angel sets up a circle of protection around us while we pray. Please stand.
The Gospel according to St. John in the 6th chapter. Jesus said to the crowd, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty." Then the Jews began to complain about him because he said, "I am the bread that came down from heaven." They were saying to one another, "Is not this Jesus, the son of Joseph, whose father and mother we know? How can he now say, 'I have come down from heaven'?" Jesus answered them, "Do not complain among yourselves. No one can come to me unless drawn by the Father who sent me, and I will raise that person up on the last day. It is written in the prophets, 'They shall all be taught by God.' Everyone who has heard and learned from the Father comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father except the one who is from God. he has seen the Father. Very truly, I tell you, whoever believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your ancestors ate the manna in the wilderness, and they died. This is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that one may eat of it and not die. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats of this bread will live forever. And the bread that I will give for the life of the world is my flesh. This is the living gospel of Jesus Christ.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Congregation may be seated. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The TV program Man vs. Food returned last year after it had been off the air for several years. It had disappeared partly because the previous host, who had been a competitive eater, decided to step away from that lifestyle that was causing a lot of problems for his health. I know, hard to believe, competitive eating might not be good for you. It's returned largely due to the fact that, the show has a lot of appeal to people. There's something about the premise of somebody testing the limits of how much they can stuff themselves, seeing how far they can go, seeing how far they can push and extend the limits of gluttony, of enduring an unhealthy amount of heat and spice. It seems that draws a lot of eyeballs to the screens. And I'm part of that. I used to watch the original version of the series years ago because I was always curious to see how he would do, whether he would overcome the challenge set before him. I think the appeal of that program is representative of something that's very pervasive around us. I think the appeal of it has to do with that pursuit that we have, that pursuit of being filled, of being satisfied, of obtaining enough, knowing that we are enough. I think the appeal of that program has to do with a hunger and a thirst within us for peace and fulfillment that still seems to continue, that we still struggle with bedding down. And it's a drive that in us moves us sometimes to feel stuffed, but not necessarily full. So it got me thinking about that particular TV program as I reflected on Jesus' words on being the bread of life. I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. There's a part of me that used to bristle at that statement, at that idea of our hunger and our thirst being completely satisfied. Because we know that elsewhere in the Beatitudes, Jesus speaks of those who hunger and thirst for righteousness. Jesus talks about those who are aching for transformation and reconciliation and justice. He talks about those who have that constant drive, that ambition to move further and further, that hunger and thirst that continues to endure. And he says that they are blessed. Because when Jesus talks about being there to satisfy our hunger and our thirst, he doesn't mean that in knowing him that we've arrived. He doesn't mean that our journey of renewal, that our journey of discovery, that our journey towards truth, that our journey of redemption and all of that work that we have before us, that work towards being a blessed community, towards understanding ourselves as brothers and sisters in the body of Christ, is done. When Jesus talks about the life that he gives for those who embrace the gospel, he's talking about hunger and thirst in a different way. And again, that image of hunger and thirst needing to be satisfied in the world around us got me thinking back to that TV show, Man Versus Food, the lengths, the extremes to which we go, and the amount to which we relate to others in their extremes, filling that space within us that can sometimes feel quite empty, even when our life is stuffed to the gills. It's well documented that while association with church and religion has fallen off over the years, the hunger and thirst for the life that Christ offers is as fierce and as strong as it has ever been. But in place of the bread of life to meet that need within us, so often we're stuffed instead with other things. As we reflect on Jesus as the bread of life, given to bring life to the world, it's useful to think on what we fill our lives with. What occupies our attention and our time and our energies? Because we're a long ways from empty, to be sure. And in fact, our hearts, our minds, our bodies, our homes, our schedules are burdened to the point of buckling a lot of weeks. But all of that isn't always the same as being filled. Because to be full with busyness and distraction is not to be filled. Much like the famous Old Testament King Solomon, we often seek completeness and fulfillment in being able to be occupied with all of our energy, all of the effort that we have. We occupy ourselves. We occupy ourselves with others, but not always with serving them, not always with understanding them. Not at looking to their needs and their experiences, but often with how we're doing in comparison to them, how much more right we might be in comparison to them. And we fill ourselves with speculations, we fill ourselves with judgments, identifying with our tribes. We carry the burden of these things to the point where we might feel too full. No time left, yet not filled. We feed on things that leave us not so much fed as tired. To be full with achievement and entitlement is not the same as being filled. Titles, recognitions, we use them as a way of sorting out, making sense of life, as a way of establishing identity, as a way of finding stability and certainty and truth. But accumulating these things doesn't satisfy our hunger and thirst for peace with who we are, because there's only one title, there's only one acclamation, there's only one recognition, there's only one descriptor that can bring that to us. That one of being a child of God before all else. To be full with validation is not to be filled. But that seeking after recognition and acceptance is a consuming part of this century so far. I was watching a television program recently. It's sort of a Twilight Zone. You remember? Some of you remember the Twilight Zone? It's a television show that's sort of a Twilight Zone for the 21st century. depicts some near future stories and settings where technology and media have led to some terrifying consequences. One of the stories imagines a world where likes and ratings from others, how many stars we get, how many thumbs up we get through phones and various platforms, determine not only a person's reputation, but determine the car that they're allowed to drive, determine the places that they're allowed to live or visit, determine where you're permitted to work, whether or not you can be trusted, and failure to get enough of these things from others is treated in this program like a modern-day leprosy. People are just shunned or locked out of opportunity and community. Like I said, the story is clearly fiction, but not always by much. We gorge ourselves on the opinions and adorations of others, even when those others might have their agendas and strings attached. Meanwhile, there is the bread of life. Jesus offers, invites us to receive into our lives that unconditional love, and to let that become the measure of our life and our value. Jesus invites us to let that strength and let that truth and let that acknowledgement abide. And let that be what fills us. Let that be. Let his light, let his example, as God with us, Jesus invites us to let that be what fuels us and what drives us, what fills that space within us seeking to be filled. And there are other substitutes to that bread of life, to be full with jealousy, with anger, or outrage, or bigotry. These emotions are occupying a large space in our conversations, in our headlines, and in our hearts. They push our buttons. They push our buttons in a way that sometimes is very energizing, but it's a bit like a sugar high. When our diet's full of junk, we have that energizing rush that's followed by a crash. Like these sugar highs, these emotions can have a disruptive influence over our brains. To receive the bread of life is choosing instead to be filled with compassion, to breathe in and breathe out with words of grace and peace. Load up on acts of mercy, words of justice and hope. These things fill us in a way that leaves us feeling more alive, our burden lightened, our minds and our hearts feeling free. This weekend at the table, we pour out the bread of life to be taken into us, be our source of light and truth. We come to be filled in a way that stops that anxious wrestling, that says, come, rest, know that I am God. It stills our spirit. We come to be filled with those promises of life that fit with those empty spaces within us like nothing else can. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Please join me in the affirmation of faith. We are not alone. We live in God's world. We believe in God who is created and is created, who has come in Jesus, the Word made flesh, the bread of life, to reconcile and make new, who works in us and others by the Spirit. We trust in God. We are called to be the church, to celebrate God's presence, to live with respect and creation, to love and serve others, to seek justice and resist evil, to proclaim Jesus crucified and risen, our judge and our hope, in life and death, in life beyond death. God is with us. We are not alone. Trusting in our loving and almighty God, who abundantly provides the bread of life to all who hunger, let us pray for the church, the world, and all who are in need. Lord God, we pray for the whole church. Sustain all who have tasted the bread of heaven and found solace in the promise of eternal life. Teach us to forgive one another in love, and to build each other up. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. Lord God, save and protect your creation. We remember the landscape being destroyed by fire in California, the haze among us. We pray that you feed, nourish, and encourage all living creatures. Teach us to practice faithful stewardship of your creation. Hear us, O God. Lord God, you rule the nations. Lead all people to speak truth and kindness to one another, but to walk in the paths of justice and peace. Hear us, O God. Lord God, we pray for those in need. Comfort those who mourn. Encourage the fearful, tend the sick. We pray especially for those we name in our hearts before you. Hear us, O God. Lord God, we pray for those gathered here today. Feed us well, so that the difficult journey of life may not be too much. Sustain us through the times of trial. Hear us, O God. And Lord God, we bless you for the lives of those faithful ones who have gone before us. Raise all at the last day, that we may exalt your name together. Hear us, O God. Almighty and loving God, we look to you in hope and trust, knowing that you will do far more than we can ask or imagine. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. We share this gift of peace.
Before we proceed with our offering, reminder of some things to come and some things ongoing. We continue this month to encourage you to contribute school supplies towards the school kits that we'll be assembling later this fall. We've gotten a healthy amount of supplies already, but we will continue throughout the month of August to have that table in the gathering area to gather those items and encourage you to contribute towards that this month. Also, a reminder to everyone that next weekend, several celebrations. We will be having a backpack blessing as part of our worship next week as we begin school. So children and youth are encouraged to bring those things in, to bring in their packs, so that they can be given a very special blessing here at church. It will also be rally day as we kick off our emphasis for Sunday mornings and Wednesday evenings. Bethany Walker will be preaching and giving the message next Sunday and emphasizing those faith formation ministries that will be officially going in September, but that we will be kicking off, next weekend. We'll also be celebrating our campers next weekend as well. So a number of celebrations to come next weekend in our worship services. We continue now with our offering. Invite all to stand as we prepare for the meal. We pray together. Creator God, we know that you have made everything in this world. You have been abundantly generous to us every day. We pray that we might show our generosity in giving back to you what is already yours. In Jesus' name. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Let's pray, asking the Lord for the grace of sharing in the heavenly meal with him. Come, let us eat, for now the feast is spread. Blessed are all who shall feast in the kingdom of God. Jesus took the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, and looking up to heaven, blessed and broke the loaves and gave them to the disciples to set before the people. Do not labor for the food that perishes, but for that which endures to everlasting, which the Son of Man will give you. I am the bread of life. All who come to me shall not hunger, and all who believe in me shall never thirst. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup. He gave thanks, and he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. It is shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." We join with one another as a family of faith as we pray in the words that our Savior taught. Our Father, who art in heaven, congregation may be seated. Come, let us eat, for now the feast is spread. A reminder to all that today, as we receive communion, we will receive by individual glasses, but we will receive in continuous fashion. So rather than gathering at the altar rail, you'll come forward, receive the body and blood of Christ, and then return out the side aisles immediately to your seats. And again, those, as always, those receiving a gluten-free host would come to the center. Welcome all to stand. May the body and the blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in true faith unto life everlasting. Amen. We pray together. O God, we thank you for the living bread that rains down from heaven. From this feast of love, may we carry your eternal life as daily food for the well-being of the world. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And now may God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine, grant you the gifts of faith and hope. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen.
Go in peace to live in Christ, as Christ's disciple. Thanks be.